The Nürburgring Nordschleife. A legend in concrete and asphalt. Early DTM era races were held on the new Grand Prix track. But as of 1988, the series took on the green hell. 25.3 kilometers on the limit for the drivers and their chariots. The distance, just four laps. Four of the toughest imaginable via Hatzenbach, Schweidenkreuz, Fuchsor, through Breidenschei, the Karussell, and Brünnchen, Schwalbenschwanz, and onto Dottinger Höhe. 85 infamous corners, every single one a knife-edge affair. The Nordschleife, a love-hate legend, even now revered as the greatest challenge in motor racing. It was the highlight of the DTM season for the fans and the drivers. Exactly 21 years ago, on the 10th of June 1993, when the DTM last took on the green hell, the biggest names were Klaus Ludwig, Alan Law, and Kurt Thiem. A very warm welcome to the Nordschleife race fans. I'm looking forward to it. It was the debut season for Alfa Romeo, the first constructor to enter a full-spec Class 1 touring car. And their lead driver, ex-Formula 1 ace Nicola Lurini, led the driver's standings going into the highlight of the season at the Nordschleife. The 120,000 crowd witnessed a farewell race packed with all the elements that make up the legend. Sensational door-to-door racing on Dottinger Höhe, four wheels off the ground jumps, and spectacular off-track incidents, all of which ended well, thankfully. To everyone's huge surprise, Lurini conquered the Nordschleife at the first attempt with two wins from two races. Alfa Romeo toppled DTM Kings Mercedes from the throne, and Lurini won the 1993 championship by almost 60 points. But it was the end of an era at the Nürburgring Nordschleife. Alan Law's off in the second race merely confirmed that the Nordschleife is unforgiving and dangerous. Too dangerous for the increasingly quick DTM cars. And so the drivers, the fans, and the series bade farewell to the Nordschleife 21 years ago.